championship.
In the AFC, I think the Titans gets to the AFC championship.
They get past who they?
They get past the Bengals. I just think Mike Vrabel is the ultimate game planner. You know, he comes from under Belichick. He is going to be able to scheme his way into this championship. And I think that defense has been playing lights out all year with Harold Landry, Simmons, you know, and Christian Fulton and them boys on the back end.
Kevin Bayard.
They've been playing phenomenal on defense. And they're going to take the Bengals, whatever they do well, he's going to take it away. If the Bengals are going to win this game on Saturday, Joe Mixon is going to have a hell of a game running the ball. If they can't run the ball consistently against the Titans on Saturday, the Titans move on. And I think that's what's going to happen. I think Tannehill makes just enough plays to be able to, you know, give them enough points. All they need is 21 to 24 points. The defense is going to handle the rest. Is Derrick Henry playing?
Yes.
He's playing. So yes. I would imagine he's going to get about 10 to 12 carries. I don't think they're going to give him a workload of 20-plus carries.
Well, I can see playoffs. Everything on the line. He getting 20.
I can see him giving about. I can see him giving about 10 to 12 carries. It's 15 at the most.
No, it's no need to. It's no need for unload management.
Packers 49ers. Packers move on. 49ers. Look, you're lucky to be here. You're lucky to be here. Jimmy Garoppolo. Jimmy G. You played like dumpster juice last weekend. You didn't play well. You almost gave the game away. Honestly.
True.
Okay. You're not having a good season. Kyle Shanahan. That lets me know just how good of a coach he is and how good and how good he understands how to put his players in position to make plays. These plays that Deebo Samuel are making, putting him at running back, giving him speed sweeps, throwing him rockets and bubble screens, that's how they're able to not give Jimmy G the ball and make him throw the ball on the field too much. Because when he does, it's going back the other way.
It's like Percy Harvey on steroids.
So I just think the Packers is going to be in Lambeau too. They move on. And then the other game with the Buccaneers and the Rams, you know, I think this is a toss-up game. But I think, you know, Matthew Stafford is going to find a way to lose it. He will find a way to lose his game on Sunday against the Buccaneers. You know, if Aaron Donald and Von Miller and Leonard Floyd, if they can't get consistent pressure on Tom Brady, it's going to be a long day.
He likes to take sacks on third down.
If they can't get consistent pressure on Brady, it's going to be a long day. And that's what it's going to come down to, getting a pass rush on Tom Brady, and it's going to come down to, can Matthew Stafford not throw the ball to the other team? So I'm going to go with the Buccaneers on that. Chiefs and Bills, I'm going with the Chiefs. I kept telling y'all since week 3, week 4, y'all was all this hoopla, they 1-4 and all this. Relax. They going to move on to the AFC Championship. So that's my picks, man. The Chiefs, the Bucks, the Packers, the Titans.
Whew, Coach Hinn.
Now let's bring some sense to this panel.
I gave you the sense.
Let's bring some sense.
Gave you the sense.
Ooh, Lord.
All you're going to do is say something similar to what I just said. Just make it sound better.
I ain't going
to
say nothing similar to what you said. First of all.
Tell me lies, make it sound good. Make first it sound of all. Good. Come on.
So I'm going to start with the Chiefs and the Bills. Chiefs and the Bills.
Wow.
The Bills going to go on.
Sean McDermott, that defense, number one defense in the league, GSportz. All the problem, you know he's a D-line coach.
Sir.
Can't go get the defense.
You know, what the Bills secondary is doing without Tre'Davious White.
Michael Hyde.
Is phenomenal.
Yeah, against the Patriots.
you counting on the Chiefs defense, which is non-existent.
Can't tackle a stool.
Right. And they best linebacker just got in trouble. He's in court right now. Willie Gay.
Mm-hmm.
Pleading to not get locked up.
But he'll be there on Sunday.
We don't know.
Help bleed.
He'll be there on Sunday.
Help bleed.
You legal shield now?
He'll be there on Sunday.
Look, just the way that Josh Allen has started this playoffs against an opponent that knows you.
Yeah.
And your first 7 drives are all touchdowns. That's amazing. That's unheard of. I just think it's just the Bills year.
Right.
I just think it's the Bills year. No way around. And look, the Chiefs got off. This is one of the main things. I don't think the Chiefs could afford to start slow. They started too slow against the Steelers. If Big Ben could have drawn a goddamn out from here to the damn wall, they might at least put up some more points early off to make them sweat a little more, because the Steelers defense was playing phenomenal.
Phenomenal.
You damn right. They didn't get the Chiefs wasn't getting first downs or nothing in the first quarter. They were going three and out.
Phenomenal.
They were playing kickball.
It ain't how you start, it's how you finish.
They're playing kickball. How did Kyler Murray? Hold on. How did Kyler Murray finish? On his back.
You knew it was coming.
If you play back the team. If you play back the team.
You know it's coming.
I never
said my neck.
One time.
My back.
Not one time.
My knee.
That Kyler Murray.
This is your MVP.
That Kyler Murray and the Cardinals was going to make a run in the playoffs. I never said that.
This is your MVP.
I said MVP Kennedy.
This is your MVP and playing my
MVP
neck.
MVP goes
back
off of the regular season. Mm-hmm. And so my that's
neck
what happened.
My
that's
back
what happened. I never said the Cardinals was going to make a
my
run in the
neck
playoffs. And
he's a winner.
Super Bowl. I never said that.
He's undefeated.
He said
they
win the division.
He's undefeated. He's undefeated.
Barely. Kyler Murray missed three games, too.
Yeah. He's undefeated since high school and all that good stuff. You know, so anywho, that's who's gonna win. The Bills are gonna win, and then on the flip side of it, I honestly believe the Bengals is gonna win.
Who they?
Simple fact, one of the reports that I've been seeing was they say Christian Fulton has been covering Jamar Chase since college.
Won't have a shot.
Which is true. Which is true. But they act like he was winning those battles.
Christian Fulton can't.
That's the issue. Like that's the issue that I was having. They act like he was winning those battles. Then also, I think just the array of ways that they can attack you. You know, you got Tyler Boyd, you have T. Higgins, you have Joe Mixon, who is quiet as kept, is probably one of the best receiving backs in the league. And then you know with the way they're running the ball. If they would have scored one more touchdown early in the game when they got toward the, I don't understand why they kept trying to just go five wide in the red zone. Hopefully he learned from that. But you know he squats like he at least
scratched my head.
Like you should at least came out 10 points in you know instead of just 6 points in out of those two possessions. And then one of the main reasons why I'm picking the Bengals, I trust Joe Burrow more than I trust Tannehill in this situation. Now, granted, this will be the first time since like one of these like week 6 that Julio Jones, AJ Brown, and Derrick Henry will all be in the lineup together. But still in all, how healthy is Derrick Henry? One. Two, the Bengals are solid against the run. So if it comes into a shootout type situation, I trust Joe Burrow to in a shootout than I trust Ryan Tannehill.
Gotcha.
Because it's not in a shootout situation. It's not, play action ain't gonna help you too much.
I gotcha. NFC.
NFC. My toss up game is the 49ers and
the Packers.
The only thing that makes me lean heavy to the Packers right now is. Right as if the game started right now, Joey Bosa can't play because he's still in concussion protocol. Nick Warner won't play. I mean, Fred Warner won't play. They still was able to get pressure against Dak Prescott without Bosa. That shows you how good that D line is. Eric Armstead is still a monster, but can you do it consistently? Dan, can you do it against a guy who is not about to take a sack, who's gonna get rid of the ball real quick? I think Aaron Jones has to have a big game, especially if Fred Warner's not going to be playing. So it's kind of a toss up. But the 49ers is not going to be scared. They brand a football. I can't name you nobody off the defense for the Packers, except Rashad Gary and Nick.
I think you got Preston
Amos.
Who?
Amos.
But
Jai Alexander, who was top five corner in the league.
He's hurt.
He not playing?
He's been out since week six.
What about Preston Smith?
Zadavius
Smith.
Smith,
Alexander's questionable.
He's questionable now. So like, but he hasn't played since week six.
Yeah, I think he's playing.
So Zadavius Smith, they best linebacker. He hadn't played since week six. They both got hurt in the same game. So it's like you're gonna have to the pass rush and all that stuff. Like it's gonna be kind of limited. It's B.J. Rogers.
For more exclusive content, subscribe to all our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. You can also find FanView Live on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and Stitcher.